Today, I welcome you again in another experiment, that is to study the pH of different soil samples, different water samples. So we have taken three samples: tap water, pond water, and RO water. Sometimes you know that in case of pond or in case of the dirty places, you can see that water, like organic substances, sometimes it accumulates on the different type of water. So just to see that how many organic substances has been accumulated or the water is leading to the eutrophication or not, we'll study the pH of the different soil samples. So I'll show you how to perform the activity.
So you can see that the water sample we have taken RO water. This one is the pond water. The third sample is tap water. So now you have to take the pH strips and just dip the pH strip into the water. You can keep it here just to see like what are the changes. We'll keep it here. Now we'll take another pH paper. It's changing exactly. The third like pH strip, you just take the third strip and dip this into the water. Now we'll take the pH meter to see the readings. So as you can see, this one is your RO water and it's almost neutral because the reading is almost like A6, so it's neutral. You can see that color has not been changed, so it's 6 only, it's a neutral. Second, the water was pond water and the pH strip, you can see the color is slightly 7, or you can say it's up to 8 exactly. And the third water sample, that is basically tap water, it's tap water. And the pH of the tap water is 7 again. It's like 7 because this pH strip has not changed properly. A little bit changes are there, so it's 7. And the second one, like we saw that it was 8, and the another one is the neutral. So I'll write the reading on the board again. So now, as you can see, that I have written the reading. Tap water has 7 pH. Pond water has 3 pH, and the RO has a 6. So you can see that this one is more alkaline water. So by reading these pH, we can see that which kind of a water is more perfect for organisms who are living in the water. So you can see the readings and you can correlate the organisms who are living in the different kind of pH with the water. So thank you so much.